Hello there. Today, I'm going to teach you how to switch between semi-automatic fire and fully automatic fire in Godot. Hope you enjoy. Let's start by creating a new scene. This will be our gun. We'll also need to add a sprite, position 2D, and a timer. First, I'll import the gun sprite. Next, I'll rename the position node bullet position, and the timer shoot speed. Basically, the position node will control where the bullets spawn, and the shoot speed will control how fast our gun will shoot. I'll move the bullet position towards the end of the gun. Because I want the gun to have a faster fire rate, I'll decrease the wait time. This will allow us to shoot much faster. Now we can add a script to the gun scene. This is where we'll code our fire types, as well as shooting and player input. Let's start by creating a preload variable. What this will do is preload the bullet scene when the player shoots. Remember to use the tscn file. Now we can start adding our variables. The first will be fire select. This will determine which fire type is being used. I'll set this to be false by default. Then we need to add the semi-fire variable, which will be false as well. Finally, I'll add an auto-fire variable, which will be true. Basically, these three variables determine which fire type is being used, and which will be the default fire type. In this case, that will be auto-fire. Now we can add a can-shoot variable, which will allow the player to shoot. This will be true by default. Next, we can add two onReady variables, which will connect both the bullet position and shoot speed timer to the script. There, we have all the variables we need for now. Let's create a shoot speed function. Click on signals and add a timeout signal to the script. This function will allow the player to shoot when the timer is reset. Now we can create a shoot function. This will be called later on. For now, let's create a variable that instances the bullet scene. We'll set its spawn position equal to the bullet position node's global position. Next, we'll add it to the current scene. Finally, we'll start the shoot speed timer and set can shoot to false. Now we can create a process function, which will allow the player to switch between semi and full auto fire. Before we do this, however, we'll need to add user input. Go into the project settings and select input map. Let's add the fire select and shoot buttons. I'll use Q for fire select and the spacebar for shoot. Now we can start coding. For debugging purposes, I'll have a message print when the player hits the fire select button. Remember to use action just pressed so that you don't need to hold the button down. Below the print statement, if the fire type is semi-fire, it will switch to auto-fire. Else if it is auto-fire, it will switch to semi-fire. This will allow the player to switch between the two fire types indefinitely. Now we can make a physics process function. First, I'll code semi-fire. If the shoot button is pressed, and the fire type equals semi-fire, the shoot function will be called. I'll also prevent the player from shooting after pushing the button, by setting can't shoot to false. Then, if the player holds the shoot button, and the fire select is equal to auto-fire, the shoot function will be called. I know that went fast, so just to recap. We created a variable that spawns bullets when we shoot. We then added three boolean variables that will determine which fire type is being used. Then we created another boolean that will determine if the player can shoot. We then created a function that allows the player to shoot when the timer runs out. Then we made the shoot function that instances the bullets when it is called, and if the player can shoot. After this, we created a process function that allows the player to switch between fire types when the fire select button is pressed. Finally, we made another function that sets the conditions for the fire type selected, and allows the player to shoot. The last thing we'll need to do is add the gun to the player scene. Click on link and add the gun scene. I'll move it so that it's in the right position. I think that looks good. Let's see if this worked. Nice. The player can shoot in fully automatic. Now let's try semi-fire. Great. As you can see, when I press the fire select button, the gun's fire type was changed. We are able to switch fire types back and forth without issues. Thanks for watching. I know that this method may not be the best, but I hope that it was able to help. Feel free to subscribe if you'd like to see more. Have a good day. See you in the next video.